Hello everyone. In the previous session, we started solving some numericals based on energy signal and power signal. We solved the first question, x of n is equal to 1 by 2 to the power n u of n, and we concluded that this particular signal is an energy signal with an energy value is equal to 4 by 3. So in this particular lecture, we will solve the second numerical, that is x of n is equal to del of n, which is a unit impulse signal, and we will check whether this particular signal is energy signal or power signal. So our first question is over. So x of n is equal to del of n. Let us first understand what exactly a del of n is. Del of n is actually unit impulse function. The functional representation of del of n is del of n is equal to 1 for n is equal to 0 and is equal to 0 for n not equal to 0. Graphically, it can be represented as if this is n, this is del of n, then at 0, we will be having an amplitude of 1, and at all other time domains del of n is equal to 0. So this is my unit impulse signal. So let us first calculate the energy value. So energy capital E is equal to summation n equal to minus infinite to infinite mod of x of n square. E is equal to summation n equal to minus infinite to infinite mod of del of n square. So as we have seen that del of n exists for n equal to 0 only, it can be written as summation n is equal to 0, the value is 1 and the result will be equal to 1. So as 1 is a finite number, or we can say 1 lies between 0 to infinity, the signal is an energy signal. Now we have also discussed that for an energy signal, the average power is always equal to 0. So let us find out the average power and check whether the average power is equal to 0 for unit impulse function or not. So average power P average can be calculated as limit capital N tends to infinite 1 by 2n plus 1 summation n is equal to minus n to n mod of x of n square. Limit capital N tends to infinite 1 by 2n plus 1 summation n is equal to minus n to n del of n square, which is limit capital N tends to infinite 1 by 2n plus 1, this value will be equal to 1, so into 1. So when we put n equal to infinity, it will be 1 upon infinity, which is equal to 0. So we can conclude that the average power P average is equal to 0. So the given discrete time signal del of n, or you can say the unit impulse function, is always an energy signal. It is not a power signal. One more thing we can discuss here is that we will separately discuss in the continuous time signal also, that the unit impulse signal in continuous domain del of t is neither energy nor power. this is a very important short question, that del of t, or you can say the unit impulse function in continuous domain, is always neither energy nor power, but a unit impulse function in discrete domain is always equal to energy signal. So this is all about energy and average power calculation of unit impulse function in discrete domain. Thank you.